mystery guest to perform his mystery was Hercules on the toilet.
Yes. Well, very nice. You're not as stupid as you look.
Thank you. I conclude that because he was afraid he would not win, he traded statues. That way, no matter who won, he would win too. Check his briefcase.
Oh, no.
I accept his brief.
Oh, no!
Quite simple, really. Really. Elementary, that is. I thought of it myself.
Good thinking, Sherlock. Except this one is fake, too.
What? What? I mean, of course it is. I knew that. Oh! I must confess, I did try to take this natural. But I'm not the culprit. Somebody else is. Monsieur Holmes had a great idea, but you're wrong. I was nothing else to touch the statue. Oh, it pains me so to say this to such a nice lady. But Madame Lambert. Used the end of, I mean the enigma, as a weapon. She's a guilty. I would suggest you check her book.
That's right, he doesn't. But you do, don't you, Helen?
Yeah.
You took the statue.
My
My word, Helen, you too? Now be a good girl and tell me where you hid that statue. Come on.
Oh, well, it's no use hiding it anymore. It's here, in my purse. I'm so ashamed. Oh.
Another.
Oh, you shouldn't be. Ladies and gentlemen of the Academy, because of the obvious duplicity and dishonesty of each and every one of our members, I submit that me, Roseanne Harris, should actually be the one to get the award. I was only smart enough to figure out who did it.
Yes, then how did you get so smart? I mean, how did you figure it out?
I am not Roseanne Harris.
No.
I am Scarlett O'Hara. I was secretary to the Academy for years. I know all of you. I know every one of your secrets. And Helen did one more thing. She's been blackmailing you all along.
That's not true.
I admit to taking the statue.
But I didn't blackmail anyone.
There's no use denying it, Helen. You wrote the notes. You stole the statues.
If you did figure it out, Rosa, then you really are a super sleuth. But let's just make sure that the statue is the real one.
It is, believe me.
Just as I suspected, it's a fake.
Figures. It was the only chance I get to get the award I deserve. The same award that every Helen Emsley deserved since my ancestor made his famous. Sherlock, if you'd only given me the credit I deserve, I never would have tried to steal the statue.
Oh, Helen, can you ever forgive me? Without my partner in crime, I would be lost.
Oh, Sheila, do you really mean that?
Oh, yes, Helen. You want to consider changing your name to Helen Holmes, would you?
Wait a minute. I'm confused. If these are the fakes, where's the real one?
Simple! Miss Rosa knows! Of course she knows. You're very clever, but you have forgotten one simple little thing. It is not the last person to have touched it, but the first person. You'll remember that after Mr. Carrot come out and said that that is the solid gold enigma, you knocked it off on the floor and pulled a switcheroony. Not exactly the natural thing for a professional woman to do. Certainly not Miss Lovelyhands. You, Rosa, were the only person who could have switched the golden enigma.
That's right. After she exchanged the real statue for a fake one, we've all been exchanging fakes for fakes, including myself. I admit to that. But I swear, I didn't blackmail anyone.
Of course not. Rosa Harry did. Or should I say, Red Harry. As Scarlett O'Hara, she had access to everyone's secrets. She said so herself. Only Rosa would know the real statue was in the podium. She put it there herself.
And I would have gotten away with it, too, if it hadn't been for all you meddling detectives. All those years of typing and filing. I never got any flowers on Secretary Day. No one took me out to lunch. I worked and worked for you guys. No one should have been able to figure it out.
Well, I wasn't the only one who did. They will now bring up the correct answers. Don't be afraid, girl. Okay, you'd like to stand here? For what? Okay, first let's do the funniest one. Okay, that'll be out of that pot.
Okay. Who stole the golden thimble? Amber Eyre? What was their motive?
How Eyre?
How did they do it?
Oh, that's lovely.
Put it in her dress.
Okay. But the winner.
Scott Crowley.
Come on up and get your award. Okay, our next winner. Who stole the Golden Enigma?
Rosie Harry.
What was her motive?
She provided all the detectives with their story plots over the years and never got recognition.
How did they do it?
She swapped the real statue for the fake one at the very beginning.
That's great, and the winner is...
Howard Zobrist.
Come on up. Hey, Howard. The Buzz ball game. Okay, who stole the Golden Enigma?
Rosie Harry.
What was her motive?
To cause a controversy to see which detective could solve the crime to find the best.
How did they do it?
With her hand.
That's
really good.
And the winner is?
Davy Ruffles.
Hey, Davy.
That's something.
These are also tickets to a bus game, isn't that correct? Bob Bedore, TV. And if you want a good time, he wrote many of the plays that were at Desert Star. And he's taken a lot of them with him. He's writing new plays, and they just opened a new show, didn't they?
Grabnet,
which is a takeoff from Star Wars. Okay. Those of you who won the bus tickets need to get with Bob Simons. Is this like the end?
And where are all you guys going when we leave here tonight?
Just you and me!
Thank you.
Recording you guys.
Well, how are these?
Is this our house?
Uh-huh.
Oh my gosh.
So look up on the mantle.
Oh my gosh.
just for until our house is built.
Oh my gosh.
That's not, we're gonna stay here.
Ricky, huh? Stand over by mommy.
We're gonna move here tomorrow. Instead of an apartment.
Are you serious?
It was a surprise since before Christmas when sharing that card. We just kept it a surprise.
Awesome.
Oh my God. Hi, Sherry. Why do you guys think the piano was in the other room over there?
Oh boy,
Did you see it?
That's what we told the kids, we had to move the piano to another apartment. They believed us. Yeah. Okay, that's why Daddy couldn't go just to the apartment and get the books. They were here.
Wow.
He had to take you to the piano lessons and come clear back here.
Oh my gosh.
So we thought we'd put your pictures up there.
Lindsay saw.
Oh boy.
Are you going with your mom after teaching or something? And I'm like, no, we should go to South
Carolina. I told Lindsay what we were doing. Said Sunday after church, we're going to let him know. We're just going to rent this from Sherry while she stays at her apartment at her mom's house.
Sherry, thank you. She's still the same.
That's
so nice
of her. Yes, we even get one of those. We even get one of those bee catchers.
It's not a bee. Isn't that a hummingbird? Oh, it is. I thought it was a hummingbird feeder.
No, that was because Don't Bust. They had taken it down. That's because the door came in there. There's some in it.
Wow. Yeah. Oh, you guys, look in the backyard.
They have a trampoline.
And it's a playset. A playset in a pool.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's very cool, right? Yeah. Do you want to go see your bedroom? Show ya. The boys will show ya. You can go see your bedroom.
I just like to sit right here.
Sherry's got three choices. She's going to stay at her mom's, go to a condo, go to Reno, or come back here. Four choices. No, she wouldn't stay at her mom's. Go to Reno, go to a condo, or come back here. So while she's deciding what she's doing, we're going to rent from her until our house is done in South Mountain. We have kept this a secret from you guys. There's no way those apartments are going to say, yeah, everybody with a pet move into one building. That was just a joke. That way when you saw me packing, you wouldn't go, what's going on? So I just had to make up a lie and say, well, the apartment complex said we needed to go to another building.
Will never trust them.
No.
They trust me so much because I never lie to them, but a surprise like this, I had to do it.
You've got a number?
Oh, yeah.
What do you think?
It's a cool house.
Yeah.
It'll be by your friends.
Yeah. This is trying to be our house.
Oh,
Ruby's is not that far away, huh?
That door.
Today we were watching Robin Hood. Piano is.
Okay.
Oh my, the piano's white.
Really? Yep, that's our piano, huh?
Leave you to this, Dad. This isn't ours. None of this stuff in here is ours.
Right.
Nope, none of it.
No, I brought more.
Always seems to drift from day to day, looking for the love never came my way. When you smile, I reach out to you.
What are you doing? Okay, today is
Sunday,
February 16th, and we're moving from this apartment on 112 South State, and we're moving into a house on the bluff back where we moved from in the first place. And we are packing right now, and we've been in this apartment for 6 months. It's 1997, and we're sick of this apartment, and we want to be in the house again. So this girl's going to let us rent her house for 3 months. Her name is Sherry, and we'll rent that while our house is being built in South Mountain. And maybe we'll get to buy her house, and then we won't have to move up to South Mountain. And that's that.
Really?
Yeah, ask Matt.
Yeah.
Ask each kid what they thought of the surprise.
Yeah. Ricky, what did you think of the surprise? Gary, what did you think of the surprise?
I thought it was dandy.
How about you?
Oh, my gosh! Okay, I got that.
I just didn't.
Did he?
No.
That was the
best. Oh, sorry, Tommy.
Ever.
Gary, I need you to go and clean your room with Ricky, and this is what I need you to do. Gary, look at me. I need you to fold all your blankets in a pile, put them over here by the door.
Okay.
I need you to put all your clothes away, and then I'm going to show you how to pack them all. Come on. You had it.
I didn't see you.
What am I supposed to do? Watch
out. Tani, I promise I didn't get you. You can watch the tape.
Okay.
Mom, watch. What's next? Oh, I forgot.
Where's the stupid willows? This is for the kids.
For the kids. For prosperity.
Yeah. Prosperity.
Trust. Well, we installed the truss yesterday.
Okay.
Moving and along.
What day is today?
Today
the 5th of March. So that looks great.
We should have all the garage ones up today, and we'll be sheeting.
Yeah, there's John. I bet he hates his video of taking, right? Yeah. Cool.
Beanie,
we stole the extension cord last time.
Stu.
Hey.
So you guys did these trusses yesterday, huh?
Yeah.
By hand.
I was scared kind of height, so I didn't contribute much other than nailing them, but yeah, they were the crane.
Well, I was going to videotape it today.
Oh, were you?
With, just to try to catch you guys with the crane or something, but I guess I missed it. So I'm videotaping anyway.
It would have been more exciting to film than today would have been.
Yeah. watching you guys slip and slide around. I didn't even come over yesterday because I figured everybody was gone. Wow. Okay, so you guys like have anything to say? This is for the kids, so you can say hi to the kids.
I've got my mouth full.
They relate to that. So this is a shot of the house from the street down here. Fun to videotape as I'm driving here. Mountains and houses and stuff. See the houses as we're coming by. There's our house right here. The trusses that are going to be going on the windows. View going up the stairs, coming into the kids' bedrooms. Here's the vaulted ceilings that are going to be right here. You can see the whole valley. There's the bluff. Look at our bedroom window this way. You can see the mountain. The ceiling vaults are going to be nice in the bedroom. So, I wonder how they're going to attach that one. Some of these trusses aren't really laying down on the walls. Like this one right here. Shaking in the wind. Now that's gonna work. Anyway, I guess that's pretty good. There's the cap. Bathroom window. Hey, all right, here they are. No, that's not that. Well, Dave, some guy's going through all your scrap wood. I guess he's looking for some wood or something. I might go out and ask him what he needs. Looks like that's it. No. Doesn't like our scraps, Dave. Where did he go?